What I'm going to show you now is a list of tables, very, very important one. To understand it, you will have to concentrate, because it's not simple at all. About all that we are going to speak about, you can see in the book Bible Codes and Kabbalah, The Secret of Creation, which I did with Professor Robert Aralik from Gander Center University in New York. And then in this book, you will have the material which explains what I am going to tell you now. Very, very important, as if we hope that we are right. So this year can be the year of Messiah, according to what you are going to see now. So let us start with the verses in the 12th chapter in Daniel. Those verses, very important one. And then we show you what we are in it. I mean, what are the things that we are taking from it. So the first thing is the verse which tells us, and from the time of the abolition of the continual burnt offering and its displacement by the mute abomination until the return in the days of the Messiah. So what is the time of it? 1,290 years. What it is exactly means, what is behind, what of idea, great secret. Then we have another verse, continuation, which says, happy is who waits 45 years behind this psalm and attains to 1,355 years. The Messiah being destined to be conceived for 45 years after he is revealed. Amazing. Then the other verse says the following, and you go to the end, to your grave, and you shall rest and arise to your lot with righteous as the end of days. Yeah, Kesaya means. So really what we are going to discuss here is this verse, case I am in, end of days. So these are the verses in Daniel chapter 12, telling us about things which are going to happen up till the time of Messiah. Now we are going to explain to you exactly what is behind, but before we have to see more about the idea, which is Kesayamin. So we have important thing from the Zohar in the beginning of the portion Mikes in Genesis says the following. And the writing of Arizal, all this says the same in Likutei Torah, is a place. So what they say is the year 5736 is a very important year. Yeah, this is Zohar says. The same thing they are reading. Definitely in my book, which I mentioned, Torah, about the Bible code and Kabbalah, I explained exactly how it came to this seal, the Zohar and everything. But important what is written that 5736, which is 1976, is a year which is very important. What was in this year? This was a year that Professor Eliyahu Rips and Doron Wilson heard about the ELS, which is equal letter sequence, is a Torah code, and the Torah started the research on it. So, very important date, 5736, and which is really 1976. This was the time that Professor Rips and Doron Wilson heard about this phenomenon from Rabbi Yaniv, the whole story is in this book. And then let us carry on and understand more important things which really will explain to us what Daniel said. Okay, so the first thing, this is a table from this book, a table which has its expression, Ketzer Yamin, the end of days, above, yeah, this is the expression, yeah, Ketzer Yamin, this is exactly what the Zohar says and what the Ari says, Arizal, that the year 5736, which in Hebrew is Eitav Shin Lamed Vav, is the year which is the end of the days, Ketzer Yamin Lemala, which is the time of the code. Now what you see here, this is from the program of the Torah code, which tells us Ketzer Yamin, this is the end of days exactly, Lemala, it doesn't come in one sentence, but it comes next to it. Then, what is the year? Unbelievable. Eight Tav Shin Lamed Vav. Eight Tav Shin Lamed Vav, 5736, which is 1976. Unbelievable. If you think, and this is the code, the word code. Now, if you think, what are the chances the end of days will come with minimal skip of the Torah, 5736, this is said with only statistics. That is very, very highly significant. So this is what Professor Aralik wrote in the book, explaining the cylinder size produced by the search and so on, everything. And then he says in the end, that this a table is small as the reduced by the Torah text is 6.5 to 100,000. Yeah, so this is what you see here. The chances of coming this is 6.5 to 100,000. Quite significant. This is what I found. Now, this is what Professor Aralik found more. I mean, this is what I found. He found that above this, you have the word sofen, which is also in Hebrew, also sofen from kod. And he says that it, looking into it, means the same thing like we saw before, Ketzer Yamin, the end of days on the 5736 above. But with the addition of sofen, it comes even to higher, which is 4.15 to 100,000. So it is more. This was found by Professor Aralik. So these two are going with what we saw before, the explanation of the Arizal and the Zohar about this date, about Ketzer Yamin Lemala, which is above, and which they said that it is this year. Yeah. Now, let us see now what is behind these numbers in Daniel. So, the number, if you remember, it was 1290. Yeah, I hope you remember. If not, this is right. This is the number, 1290 years. And another one was what you have here, 1,350. It means it was 45 years more. Yeah? So we have the two numbers, important one, 1190, which is the number 1,290 years, and then 45 years more, we have the year, which is 1,300. Then, let us see amazing gematria of all this. So this was the end of days above, right? Ketzer Yamin Lemala. The numerical value of this come to 1,290. This is according to gematria. When we take the final, yeah, the final with the continuation, 400 is tav, and 500 and so on, final mem and five noon and final pay. So the final tzaddik comes to 900. So together, 100 and 900 is thousands. And lemala above is 100. It means it comes, the word Ketzer Yamin Lemala. This is exactly in the Daniel number 1790. Now plus 45, yeah, come to 1335. Yeah. Now what you have it in the years, because 1976 was 1219 plus 45, 2021, our year, this year. 5736 45, also 57 this year. Unbelievable. So you have indication, clear indication in the prophecy of Daniel to this year. But as we said, you need repentance. So it is unbelievable. I think it is really, oh, but there is a last one really. There is a last table which really tells us about the end of days. I mean, now, so here you have end of days, Kese Amin, and you have unbelievable letter after letter in 5781, 2021, and again 2021. No, the commandments of God which you have to keep, and then the Messiah parallel, which is also very significant. By the way, you have also Daniel here. Maybe indicates it to Daniel, because the prophecy of Daniel. So, looking into verses, also the same thing. God says, "Shavtotai tishmoru." You should keep my Shabbat. "Shatirah v'ni Hashem." "Berugotai telechu." Clearly, God said, if you want Messiah, if you want redemption, the end of days, so this is what you have to do. If you follow my laws and faithfully observe my commandments, and really this is the first part, you should keep my Sabbath. And when my sanctuary, I am the Lord. So definitely to venerate, to sanctify the sanctuary, this is what we should do, to keep the Shabbos, and also to observe the commandments. Then God promised us very good thing. Then God said, if you will listen to me, you keep my mitzvot, for I give to you possess a land flowing with milk and honey. I, the Lord, am your God who has set you apart from other peoples. Amazing. So this you should know. Israel should know they are different from the other nations. They have to keep 613 mitzvot, and the Gentiles have to keep 7. So all together, as I said, to understand it properly, we'll have to get my book, Bible Course in Kabbalah. And Kabbalah, this is, you can get in Amazon.com or GlazersonBooks.com. You can read it in Kindle. But if you want to understand this properly, but as I said in the beginning, it is unbelievable, because interpreting and explaining these verses in Daniel about the end of time, number 1290, number 1335, and all this connected with Kese Amin, the end of days. So this is what I think, and it will be based on Kabbalists who say this really part in he spoke about the meaning of these numbers. It's a book which is not a book, it is really called Soda Hashmal. It is a really weekly things about the portion of the week. So this is really what we brought here. It's there in Hebrew, Soda Hashmal. So as according to the explanation that we brought a lot, connecting the code with the end of days, everything goes together. So as I said, to understand this fully, there is a Zohar appears, there are recess, should get the book. But meantime, I think that if you follow those tables which I have, what Daniel says, and then you will see what the Ari says. And the Zohar says about 5736, 1976. And you can see the very significant table about this. And then, hoping that really this year will be the end of days, and we'll marry to have a wonderful land, you know, full one with all the borders. But, yeah, we have to keep the Sabbath. Sabbath is one of the most important commandments, according to Rabbi. Sabbath is equal to the whole commandments. So if Jews dedicate the Shabbat, as unfortunately we see today, they don't keep the laws. So we have difficulties to get the full land and to have peace and quiet. But the Maimonides said, right, Israel will not be redeemed unless they repent, do tshuva. But God promised they will do. Why? Who knows? Because of the corona, because of Iran, who knows? But as I said, what you are going to see in this book, Bible and Kabbalah, which we did with Professor Aralik, you will have a lot of material to explain it. But meantime, the idea, you got the basic idea. The basic idea is, as he said, that these two numbers represent the end of days above and the end of days down on earth, hoping that really this year, which we have many tables and YouTubes, clearly shows that it's very, very significant here, this one. So we're hoping that really we'll have the Messiah coming soon and bring peace, tranquility, happiness, and joy to the whole world.